many things in this world is awesome. I'm one of them. The power of the good Lord is another. And this week's Globe. This is really awesome. Check that out. It's the Hillary gay love scandal. Big deal. Everybody already knows about that. Even more awesome than that, which is common knowledge and has been for years, we got this sweet article. Look, Paris and Benji's dog fight. Look at that dude. Oh, is that a crisp focus? Or is it not? Well, let me tell you something here. This article says she's got 17 dogs, which is really cool. And she won't spay or neuter any of them. Also cool. Dogs live for two things, food and sex. And if you take their sex away, they don't got much to live for. That's why the neutered dogs always get big and fat, because then they only have the food to live for. So you got to let your dog get its jollies and go to town, because that's the meaning of life. She can afford to feed the damn things. She thinks like the ski mask. Get a nice wide shot here. She's got like 17 dogs. I got like over 60 of these fluffy birdies. Oh, yes, I do. Which is also cool. Oh, I think Paris Hilton, I'm going to psychoanalyze her because I'm a psychologist and I am a mature psychomimologist. But still a psychomimologist with a degree from Dudley's Cosmic Space Pouch University. Fool! She's obviously very lonely. She had that TV show, that Best Friends Forever thing. And lonely girls will put up with a lot of guff from a duff boyfriend. Like some total zero piece of crap. Like, look at this. Get a close-up on this, man. She's got this loser here. He's in favor of castrating dogs. The dude's got a double chin. He's in a horrible band, Good Charlotte. His music's uber lame. Ditch this zero. She's real lonely, so she's putting up with guff from some loser. You could do a lot better than this idiot. You could get tons of men who are actually nice and get it. Like I got Dudley! Where's Dudley? Me and Dudley went to the record theater together! Because we go shopping together, we do all kinds of things together! Including seducing the viewer's mother together. Dudley, I got him some Paris Hilton vinyl. And you might not believe it's vinyl. But it is, and it's got a pink label on it, which is Dudley's favorite color. People always ask me, who puts out vinyl nowadays? Well, really sweet people like Paris Hilton put out vinyl. And me, because I'm the best damn producer in the city. Look, it's the new Corpus Day. Look at that sweet picture of Doug Luke. It looks sort of like the Paris Hilton cover shot. It's a glamour shot. Very similar. See? And also this sweet record that I produced, also done, did, came out. It's the running for cover, Dark Well. Look at that beautiful record. And Elvis Cosma Mostello, it said in the Gusto, just came out with record. Get me that Gusto over in that there, and I'll pull it out. Like when I pull out on the viewer's mom, and I give her a pearl jam necklace like this. Find the Elvis Costello in there. Look, Professor Griff also puts out records, and he's sweet. People!
Vinyl double L.
Yeah, look at that. Look at, get a close up on that. Look, Elvis Costa Mostello. He put out a double vinyl only album, and that's sweet too. All the kids like vinyl now. You corporate overlords who tried to kill the vinyl so you could get more of the royalty cut from the CDs. Look at the CD. The CD's real sweet. It's Captain Beefheart's Trout Mask Replica. And look, I got a picture of Paris Hilton, and she's holding Trout Mask Replica in her claws there. Because she's a fan of good music like the Ski Mask and Dudley. Oh, we all like Trout Mask Replica, as do you, the viewer. That's one of your favorite frickin' albums, you morons. Speaking of sweet, sweet, sweet publications, look at the Art Voice cover. The birds, they did a cover story about my birds. There's pictures in there of Red Polt, Peppermint, Doodly, Butterscotch, Green Duck, Buff Orpington, and Bertha. Bertha's named after Phil Spector's mother. Where's that Phil Spector record? Yeah, his publishing company was called Mother Bertha Music. Look at the Righteous Brothers. He produced some of the tracks on this. But what the hell is going on here? Get a real nice close-up. There's some weird some weird homoerotic stuff going on. What the fuck's going on there? And there, where's the one where they're getting in the car? That's a pretty weird one too. And like, look at that. He's spotting weights for him. He's lifting his weight in the weight room. It's like at the gym by Man to Man. Oh, Man to Man were produced by Henry Belolo. And Henry Belolo, before he produced Man to Man, he produced these. He produced these. Got a class sweet close up on these. The Village People, which ties in with Hillary Clinton's gay love scandal, because it takes the Village People to raise your rotten children. I don't know where my paper went because, oh, there it is. There it is. Quick instant insert. There. It takes the Village People, and that ties in with gay love because the Village People are all about gay love, as is the viewer's father, because the viewer's mother is so rotten that she made him switch to the other team. It's like when the Bo Sox traded the Bambino to the New York Yankees, and the curse of the Yankees will never be lifted, and the Bo Sox will never win a Super Bowl or a Stanley Cup or a Paul Stanley Cup, because Kiss were on this label. Close up on the Casablanca. Neil Bogart owned this label. And then there's that song, Don't Bogart That Cosmic Space Egg, which is about Dudley and his favorite substance of abuse. Like, Paris Hilton takes abuse from that Benji Madden character, from that god-awful bad Charlotte Band moron. You don't spay Tinkerbell. You don't cut the balls off no chihuahuas at Paris Hilton's compound. It's like the government going in and arresting Mormons for having 5 wives and 20 children. What the fuck is up with that? I got a prophecy of the end of the world from the newspaper, if I can find it. Where's that frickin' fracking Buffalo News? Well, I only had 3 minutes last week, so I'll just make up for it this week. We're waiting for the guests to arrive. Look at that. This is the end times prophecy. They're forbidding the sale of birdseed to feed pigeons in Venice. And Venice is in Rome, where the Vatican is. And the Vatican's the Whore of Babylon. And the Pope is its leader. Chew on that.
Okay, this is a poem by my favorite local poet, James Earl Prey. I think it's called Don't Ever Give Up on Life. I'm not sure, though. That's kind of weird right off the bat. Don't ever give up on life. I've seen this guy give up on life more than anyone I know. All right. We all go through hard times in life. Tell me about it. It's brutal. I can't fucking take it anymore. It's horrifying. Maybe you were abused by a priest. I was. Yeah. That was when I was an altar boy in third grade. It was fun, though. Cut your yayas out. Maybe you were bitten by a shark. I was. He bit off half my leg. Left leg. Maybe you were barely burning a fire. I was. It's like this. It's like a crystal ball here. Maybe you broke a leg playing football. I did. I broke a leg playing football. It was my half leg. The one that half was bitten off by a shark. Maybe you had cancer. I did have cancer. Oh my God. That was a horrible experience. I'm not sure what was worse, having half my leg bitten off by a shark or being abused by a priest. No, that was good. So it had to be the shark or the fire or a cancer. Maybe you had a stroke. I did have a stroke. Oh my God. Wow. It's just like my horoscope. Maybe you had a bad car accident. I did have a bad car accident. Oh my God. Maybe you were struck by lightning. I was. Maybe you served time in prison. Well, that kind of reminded me of my experience with the priest, actually, the time in prison. Maybe you were severely wounded in a war. I was, a war with a shark. Maybe you were mauled by a beet. I don't get that. Maybe you were mauled by a beet. Jim must have been drunk when he wrote this. Maybe you were mauled by a beet. Yeah, man, I was. I remember I went to Thanksgiving dinner and I was mauled by a beet. That was a drag. These things don't last forever. Oh, thank God. Ugh. Time eventually heals all wounds. Bullshit. I need some closure. Look ahead, not behind. Look ahead, not behind! This was for the man who told me for 2 years he wasn't getting any closure in his life. He writes a poem saying, look ahead, not behind. Oh, my God. Maybe he should have read his own damn poem. Because some windows of opportunities are very small. That's true. It's hard to get through. There's always hope for better things to come. That's bullshit. You think if I have cancer, I'm bitten by a shark, I'm abused by a priest, I'm burned in a fire, I break my leg playing football, I have a stroke, I'm in a bad car accident, I'm struck by lightning, I serve time in prison, I'm wounded in a war, and I'm mauled by a beet? You think that means there's gonna be better things to come? Not necessarily. With all that shit, you're probably just laying on your deathbed. Look above at the birds flying high on a sunny day. Look at them flying high on a sunny day. The birds flying. Look at them. Yeah, that cheers you up. You got cancer. You had a stroke. You got half your leg bitten off. You were in a car accident. You've been in prison. You've been abused by a priest. So you're psychologically damaged. But look at the birds flying high in a sunny sky. That's going to cheer you up. Look at a beautiful sunset. Oh, yeah, that'll put all the cancer, stroke, and accidents away. And watch the water glistening from the sun's reflection. Why didn't Jim do this? For 2 years, he told me every day, I'm not getting closure. I'm upset I'm not getting closure. I didn't see him looking at any beautiful sunsets and watching the water glistening from the sun's reflection. Knowing your past is behind you. Here it is again. Live your life one day at a time. I told Jim for 2 years to know his past is behind him and move on. But did he do it? No. And then he writes a poem saying, live your life one day at a time. You can't have a high without a low. Well, that's true. Knock down the brick wall, one brick at a time. Knock down that wall. Mr. Gorbachev, let the anguish and the tears make you stronger. Yeah, that really worked for Jim. God gave you one life. Oh, I know, it sucks. One damn life. What about reincarnation? Come on. And today may be the last day of your life. Oh, God, I hope it is. So make the best of it. Thank you for these pearls of wisdom from James Earl Prey. On drum pad, on bass guitar. Okay, take it down. Don't ever give up on life. We all go through hard times in life. Maybe you were abused by a priest. Maybe you were bitten by a shark. Maybe you were badly burned in a fire. Maybe you broke a leg playing football. Maybe you had cancer, baby. Maybe you had a stroke. Maybe you had a bad car accident. Maybe you were struck by lightning. Maybe you served time in prison. Maybe you were severely wounded at war. Maybe you were mauled by a beet. These things don't last forever. Time eventually heals all wounds. Look ahead, baby, not behind. Because some windows of opportunities are very small. There's always hope for better things to come. Look above at the birds flying high on a sunny day. Look at a beautiful sunset and watch the water glistening from the sun's reflection. Knowing your past is behind you, live your life one day at a time. You can't have a high without a low. Knock down the brick wall, one brick at a time. Let the anguish and the tears make you stronger. God gave you one life, and today may be the last day of your life, so make the best of it, baby. Yeah.
I'm going to read a poem that was written by my favorite talk show host, Greg Stirlis. Stirlis. My baby. We're at a drive-in movie. My baby's eating lots of junk. She's got her hand down my pants because she thinks I'm a hunk. I play on the football team. It makes her want some romance. Neither of us have a brain, but the important thing is she has her hand down my pants. I love her and she loves me. Oh, how happy I can be. I can use her for her money and for sex because she's my honey. I think I'll kill myself.
Jim Prey, you butchered that poem. You changed it.
Yeah, anyways.
Butcher.
Yeah, thanks for changing my poem there, Jim.
No respect.
I thought
maybe
I did a good
two
job.
Hands are too much.
We're here with
she had her hands down.
It might
his
be
pants.
Overstimulation.
She's really into it.
That might be overstimulation.
No, because like one grabs the grapes and the other one grabs the Vienna sausage.
Or the grapes and the nuts.
What is this? Is this a
the grapes and the nuts like grape nuts?
Grape nuts, yeah.
Yeah, is this grape nuts.
Is this all a culinary right. cooking show? Is that what we're talking about?
Anyways, I'm here
about?
With all the regulars. We got Mr. Turd Bacon Ski Mask.
Yes, that's
that
him.
That means that's
we're irregular.
That's pig turds making the bacon. I'm here with the irregular cast of the show. We got Mr. Turd Bacon Ski Mask, which means
it's a tasty feast.
It's like so you take pig turd and you make it into bacon.
Yep.
And then we got Paula Turd Bacon Vahoviak. And that's like what you take pig turds, turd bacon.
I'm not a.
We got Jim turd bacon prey.
We got Dudley.
And we got Dudley turd bacon Dudley. And then we got me. And the thing is, tonight we're supposed to have Pam Swartz, music genius, on a show. And you can see she's not here. And her boyfriend Vic Lazar, they're supposed to be here doing their music, and they just stiffed me. As she's wont to
they
do.
They gave you a stiff, high, hard one, buddy.
Now, which one did that, Vic or Pam?
I don't know. We'll find out. We'll get to the root of this matter.
That sounds like he might find it entertaining.
Stiff, hard, high one sounds good.
Yeah.
I'm glad they gave me that. They did that.
Wow.
But, so they just, Pam seems to, I'm very disappointed and sad because Pam doesn't really have any respect for me, it seems.
You feel
like
a sad clown?
Yeah, I feel like a sad clown, exactly.
Yeah, it's very
And Jim,
sad.
You are a sad clown, right? So it all ties together.
He's a sad clown, he's like John Casey.
I'm not a sad clown.
You seem like a sad clown. Are you sure you're not a sad clown?
No.
You're a sad clown.
Okay. Doesn't he seem like a sad clown to you?
Yeah.
Yeah, he's a sad clown.
I brought three
Is that
things.
How you like being referred to, Jim, as a sad clown? Like my friend Jim Pratt, a sad clown?
No, a person that's trying to lose weight.
A person who's trying to lose weight.
He's trying to gain weight. The end times are coming. You're going to need to bulk up for like
for the end times. For the end times. You can't get
you
rice nowadays.
Drop off, though?
You got to live
mean,
off your fat like a manatee.
I mean, Mr. Ski Mask, wouldn't you just want to drop off if that was going to happen? You wouldn't want to like live through it.
No, he
wanna
live
you
got to
live
it.
Off your fat. Everyone's got to bulk up, get big and fat.
Okay.
Eat lots of donuts.
All right.
Donuts are not healthy.
And Joe Weider's bodybuilding steroid formula wheat shakes at the health food hippie store in the jug. Whatever the hell that thing's called.
Should I?
I love
I
that
not,
magazine.
Should
you
I
ever
not
cleanse
give?
Your colon, a colon cleanse?
No. Anyways.
Try it sometime. Jim Frey.
Meanwhile, back to Greg.
Hey, ever drink Smooth Move tea, buddy?
Hey,
turd bacon ski mask is entertaining the public out there.
Yeah, I'm entertaining.
Look how boring the three of us are. Look how entertaining Mr. Turd Bacon Ski Mask is. He's way more entertaining than us. Oh, no, sorry, Paul. No, this is the two who are very entertaining.
Should I not give Pam those things now?
Well, for instance, Paula, you brought Pam clothes.
I gave her
you brought Pam
her clothes, three things.
And we don't, and
clothes.
She doesn't. But now
we got clothes.
Now this is
a dress and a pair of pants and a fake fur skunk jacket.
Give it to Greg.
Yeah, he's gay.
I don't think Greg would fit in it though.
Oh, then don't give it to Greg. Who would fit in it? Jim Prey?
How about Lindsay?
Would Lindsay fit into it?
Lindsay, I don't know. I could give it to Lindsay. It's a skunk coat.
Oh man, it's a skunk coat.
It's not really a skunk. It's a fake fur.
All right. So anyways,
dude, I got something on a Rick James's.
Oh my God! You stop.
Singer.
You don't have to reference everything with useless music.
Where's Rick James?
Look
man.
How interesting the three of us are, and how boring he is.
Rick James, fool!
Is he wearing
Rick
that
James?
Coat?
Anyways,
he would.
I'm still alive. I'm sick of all these props. Greg, get rid of these props.
Yeah, Chuck, get rid of these props. Jesus.
I'm a prop comic. I'm like Gallagher.
All right, so let's call Pam up, and we'll get her voicemail. And you can give her a piece of your mind, Chuck, for not showing up. Yeah, let's give her the business. Let's call her up now. And Vic,
the good band
Vic and her,
England. The
Chuck, you give them a piece of your mind. Why don't we get it?
Okay.
How about you? You giving a piece of your mind, too?
We're calling Pam Schwartz.
You do it first. You jump in there and give a piece of your mind.
What if they actually answer?
Len, talk. Give her a piece of your mind.
And that would be fun.
Yeah, it'd be even more fun if they answer. The count and the amount.
Seven rings.
She must have an answering machine, right? An answering. She's got an answering something.
It's a voicemail.
Yeah, no, I know. I can't remember what those things are called all the time.
This is Pam. Leave a message.
Record your message after the tone. To send a numeric page, press 5.
Sicker scheme.
When you are
sicker.
Finished recording,
hold on.
Hang
up. For the beat.
Or for delivery right. options, press pound.
There you go.
I'm leaving a message on behalf of the almighty Spurlack, who has been disrespecting my vacated. Where is you? Why ain't you on the TB
to
show?
Replay your message.
Dudley!
Press 1.
Oh, it's already
to
over.
Continue recording, press 2. To delete and re-record your
press
message,
two?
Press
2.
At the tone,
let's call her other
please
number.
Continue recording your message.
Oh, we're continue.
Oh,
Pam,
where am
I brought you?
You
some clothes and you didn't come. I brought you three things. I
Dudley
told you
hurt.
I was going to bring you things.
Dudley had tough questions
to
for you.
To replay your message, press 1. To continue recording, press 2.
We
to
have
delete
to
and re-record your message, press 3.
Tough questions.
For delivery
tough.
Options,
tough.
Press 4.
Tough
to
questions.
Cancel this message, press star.
Like the roast
to
beef
send
at your host.
Now,
tough.
Press pound or hang up.
Wow, this is a really complicated answering
tone,
machine.
Please continue
machine
recording
sucks
your message.
We are... What tone?
Go ahead.
Okay, go ahead.
Hey, why are you disrespecting the Spurlock? You disrespect the Spurlock? Get on the TV show. Get down here. Where's the TV show? Get down here.
Anyways, Pam, I'm wondering why...
Why are you hurting the Spurlock?
Why do you keep hurting my feelings all the time? I don't understand.
How can you make the Spurlock cry?
He won't,
hey, very nice.
You won't put bad vowel in any of your Nietzsche's bills when you set gigs up. And even when I mention to you, I tell you how sad I am about it, nothing happens. And then I book you and Vic for the show. Neither of you show up. Neither of you call or anything. I don't understand. Why? What did I do? Why am I being persecuted like this? Is it me? Is it I'm wrong? Am I... It's a lot of sadness inside my heart. Anyways, I'm very sad and I'm very disappointed.
He feels really bad. I mean, he's not being sarcastic.
No,
here.
I'm not being sarcastic.
Feels like
not
been
at all.
Really nailed sad to the cross.
I feel like I've been nailed
Kenny
to the cross,
Vaughn,
like Kenny Vaughn. What?
Yeah.
No, I don't. That's freak that part.
Remember when Kenny Vaughn was nailed to the cross because
no,
his father ate breakfast with his friend?
I don't feel that way.
That's how you feel.
No, I don't feel that
way. Makes you into a sad clown.
That's right. The same way Ken was upset that he didn't get to go to breakfast with his father, I'm upset that you have so little respect for me and you. I guess I don't know what I did to deserve this. I feel sad and lonely.
It's all like right, they're choosing Barabbas.
Well, not lonely.
You
sad
know?
And disappointed.
You know how Jesus felt when they chose Barabbas? That's what's going on.
I feel just like the yeah Barabbas thing, yeah.
Yeah, the Barabbas thing.
All right, thanks, Pam. All right, anyways.
She got
I have tough questions for you, too.
Another number?
Yeah, she has another. Let's keep calling all her numbers.
That's entertainment.
Oh, man.
That's entertainment.
Want to call our other number and see if we get that?
Are you singing the Jam song?
Ducks.
You like Paul Weller?
Ducks are fun.
All right, so since we have you here, Chuck, let's figure some things out about you.
All right, number, good luck.
Ducks are fun. See my
what do you
duck,
know?
It's
can
yellow
I ask,
and white.
Scheme has some questions.
Yeah, that's ask him. Go ahead. We got time for that because Pam's not here.
I was going to ask him about their beliefs in the Lord.
Listen up, Ski Mask.
Why?
And we like each other.
Hold on,
so you can learn something.
From who? You?
Why do you keep saying that there's no good mothers and fathers?
Because incarnation on this earthly plane is a curse. Who wants to be incarnated here? The goal is to reach nirvana and get out of here, isn't it, pal?
Well, all you got to do
yeah,
is...
But you can live
well,
a
you just put
life
a gun in your mouth and blow your head off right now, Chuck. I mean, what do you...
Hell,
you
know? No one's happy, not even Paris Hilton.
Oh, she's
and
happy.
And she's rich.
She's super happy.
She's freaking happy.
She ain't happy.
Of course she's happy.
No,
what do
she's
you think?
Not. She's.
When did you?
Are you projecting? You're projecting, Mr. Scheme.
No. Yes, you're projecting.
I'm analyzing because I'm a psychomanologist.
A psychomanologist.
You need a psychomologist. I know that.
Psychomanologist. I
you need
know
a psychomanologist. I'm a
one. I prophesy.
We learned something new. He's a psychomanologist.
Yeah.
Channel the truth from the cosmos.
Psychomanologist.
The cosmic egg has all the truths of the world in it.
Now,
and
Chuck, what
is a cosmic egg? A testicle.
Chuck.
Is that a testicle?
Could be.
No, I'm wondering.
To me, that like, yeah.
What happened? Why did you start putting the ski mask on? That's why I kind of always wondered.
So that's
one
cold
day when you were
live in Buffalo. What the fuck else would I put it on?
Okay.
It snows here
it's
in
very
August.
Logical.
It snows here in July. Don't you ever listen to Johnny Carson give his monologues? Johnny Carson does not lie. He's Karnak the Magnificent. He always tells the truth. So if he says it snows in Buffalo in summer, it does.
Yeah,
and it does. That's why I wear this thing. It's always cold here. Why did Crystal Beach closed? Because I couldn't stay open because it was always snowing and no one could go to the beach.
Right.
Yeah, but it's
all right.
Are you sure one of the reasons you don't wear this ski mask is because you say such offensive things? You're afraid somebody might recognize you outside.
Kick your ass?
Yeah.
Is that what?
Well, okay, well, how about with the next show you don't wear the ski mask?
Then I wouldn't be the ski mask.
Right, he wouldn't be Mr. Ski Mask then.
And are you really supporting Obama or you just wear all his paraphernalia for
I'm
kicks?
I'm supporting his freaking preacher.
This is your camera.
Jeremiah Wright is my favorite. I love that Jeremiah Wright guy.
Because he hates America
no,
like you do?
No, he just tells the truth. He loves America. He's good at tough love. You ever hear of tough love, buddy?
Yeah, you've given me a lot of that over the years.
Tough love, huh? Tough
he
love.
He gave him tough love.
Right,
Jeremiah Wright for president.
I'm sorry, little Jim Pray here has
Dale
another
Sharpton
question
for
you.
I got another question.
Yeah.
Why did you say before that a woman giving birth is a very selfish, gross, unnecessary thing for a woman to do?
The hen said that, but it's true.
Well, why is it true?
Because they're thinking about carrying on their own genetics and they're thinking about themselves first rather than the suffering that child's going to have to go through, like regents exams and paying high taxes. and getting diseases and dying
and
starving
wearing a ski mask
and,
if they live
and
here.
The apocalypse, which is coming. Everyone, the apocalypse is coming. Now, the world's going to end in 2012. You know that.
Yeah, I know. I heard it. Rush said that, right?
Yes.
You know that.
Now, I'm a priest of the Temple of Syrinx.
So yes, you are.
So are you saying...
We are the priests of the Temple of Ceres!
You like that, you fool?
No.
Don't let him call you a fool, Jim. Punch him out.
That's like freaking Beavis.
Kick his ass.
Shit, that's awesome.
Well, who's got the ski mask and the turban on?
Yeah. Now, Mr. Ski Mask, do you realize you do this a lot when you get all excited?
Yeah.
You realize you're doing that? Is it, or do it just happens?
I'm rocking out. You know that expression, rocking out? That's what it means. I'm channeling the universe, man. I'm getting the cosmic vibrations to the cosmic egg, and I'm rocking out. Like, I'm listening to a Ronnie James Dio album.
Wow.
Wow.
All right,
he's got some good answers here. You got to admit, Jim. Anything else you want to ask him?
Good answers. They're your freaking questions.
How come
your questions blow, Jim.
Oh, man,
they blow. They're so boring.
How come you keep on saying ridiculously say that all sex is gay sex?
Yeah, all sex is gay sex.
Because everybody is part egg or part sperm. Therefore,
everyone do this.
All come women on. Have part of their mother in them and part of their
that
father.
Makes no sense whatsoever.
So you got part of a sperm, so you're having
this is your camera over here.
You're having sex with
a narcissistic bastard.
Yeah.
You're looking at yourself in the monitor the whole time.
You have sex with someone.
Instead of looking at the people.
You're vicariously having sex with that person's mother and father.
No, you're not. No, you're not.
Code.
That's ridiculous.
So you're fucking your girlfriend's father at the same time you're fucking your girlfriend, so it's gay sex.
No, you're not.
Because part of her father's is in there because she's half of his sperm from his ball sack.
I understand the reasoning
but I don't agree with it. Very faulty reasoning.
You agree, you just don't realize it yet, but you will come to agree because my prophecies always come true, and you know this.
I do.
Look at Spitzer.
I know.
I can see through his lies.
Well, everybody out there in TV land, this is what happens to you when you start taking LSD at 4 years old.
Yeah.
It's a beautiful thing.
Yeah, but you make no sense.
I make sense. To be enlightened. Those with gnosis. Gnosis. Or the Illuminati.
He's a Gnostic. Don't you know that?
So are you saying that you're a virgin and you're never going to have sex because you don't want to ever be a mother and father? And that?
No, you put it in a plastic bag, you moron. You stick in the boner bag.
There's your camera over here.
That sounds really fun.
You narcissistic bastard. That's you know,
All right. Yeah, great.
I thought you would care because you're on television.
If it don't work, you get the wire hanger.
Yeah, of course. No more wire hangers.
No more wire hangers.
Joan Crawford. Like the Blue Oyster Cult hit, Joan Crawford has risen from the grave.
That was a big hit.
Yeah, that was a big hit.
I had a lot of those singles of that. I bought all five of them.
Come on, Jim.
Well, actually, you're gonna be performing at Mama Palooza.
Yeah, with you.
Which is a very
now,
ironic.
How do you feel about that? You're going to be playing at Mama Palooza.
It's all moms. Moms who rock.
Horrible thing, and now you're going to be playing with all the
not
mothers.
Not necessarily mothering is a horrible thing, but the process of giving birth and trapping a spirit in flesh.
You're using your regular voice there for a second. Did you realize you just did that?
I don't have a regular voice. I got a bunch of weird voices.
You were doing that. You were doing it like a normal human being for a second. Yeah, I caught you.
No.
We have it on videotape.
He just had a little frog
tape
in his
lies.
Throat.
You can edit it. You edited that in.
Well, here's
I edited it.
Here's another question for you.
Be a good
you
one.
Got a lot of good answers, I must say, to all these things.
A lot of
us good. Come on, fool.
You are entertaining the people out there in television,
all
right. Man. It's not
bring
us.
It, fool.
It's
how much?
Bring it. Chickens are coming out on a roost.
All right, shut up for a second.
I got the word of God in my mouth, fool. Come on.
Yeah, shut up for a second when he's asking you a boring question.
All right.
Come on, let me ask you another boring question here.
Sleep. Come on.
Okay.
Yeah. Whether a dog or a cat.
How much is a ski mask belief the Chuck Fury?
My phone's ringing.
Chuck Fury.
What word?
Huh?
Probably Pam.
Yeah.
Hey, Pam's calling. Where's Pam?
Should we clip?
Though. No.
Where's Pam?
Oh. Cares.
Clop.
What's the difference? No, not clop. We got a minute left.
All right. How much is Chuck Fury? Can you do something about him?
This is great TV. He's been on fire this whole segment. You and Paul and I have been doing nothing. But he's been great this whole segment.
I've been playing with the platypus. What do you mean doing nothing?
So that's what I'm saying. None of us have really done anything.
That's great TV. So
I'm playing with my platypus.
He hasn't kept repeating himself. He said a lot of interesting things. Why don't you watch the playback later and see how good it was, Jim?
I'm watching.
This is the most entertaining 15 minutes ever.
Skin oboe, Jim Prey.
I'm playing with my platypus.
You're playing with the skin oboe.
Yeah, he's playing the skin oboe. Of course, we all play with the skin oboe at one time or another.
You're the band leader. You play
Skinless. I like Skinless
Mofo. You know what I'm saying?
Skinless
Mofo. Good, you know. You know,
yeah, he's the leader of the band. Roost,
you know what I'm saying? Chickens coming home to roost. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, no. Yeah, they are coming home to roost.
And we start bombing in 5 seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1.
We're coming home to roost.
Zero.